Aloha mai kākou, a call mai the curtain call from a distance, a program of reviews, previews, interviews, and features of and or with the great art and artists on Maui and beyond. I'm Paul James Brown, and I'm coming to you from my home office where I have been conscientiously practicing self-isolation. Oliver Purs, director of Viewpoints Gallery in Makawa, has distributed 300 10-inch by 10-inch panels to 96 invited artists to date from throughout the state. To create a mural through the eyes of the artists is meant for these select artists to interpret the 2020 COVID times, a period like no other in just about everyone's lifetime, a perfect time to call upon creative individuals to share their feelings about this unprecedented event. The mural has expanded to take over the whole of the front of the gallery. Each artist has submitted a statement about their work. While these are instructive as to the intention of the artist, however, isn't that what visual art is all about? To communicate thoughts, feelings, ideas, emotions without words? These statements are by and large eloquent and heartfelt, but they are unnecessary and superfluous, and they are not visible on the mural, only on the gallery website, or you can ask to see a particular one if you like. The mural has grown from 80 to 212 panels. There are so many notable ones, I will be doing two shows on part two, and I suspect there will be a part three before the year is over. Part two looks at a few months into this collective nightmare we are sharing. As might be expected, the works run the gamut from confusion to skepticism to fear and hope. William Houston's photorealistic oil on panel of giant sea turtle portions, entitled Shelter in Place, is a reminder. This creature, when it is beached, is one of the most implacable characters on the planet. When it finds its place on the beach, there it stays until it finally moves inexorably to the sea when it is good and ready. It will not be hurried and it will not move until it is set. So it is with this pandemic. We should all stay in a safe abode until it is finally clear for us to emerge. Tracy Dudley is another realistic painter. This acrylic work on panel needs no explanation. It entreats the viewer to do what is right, pono. This means following the CDC guidelines, wear a mask, observe social distancing, wash your hands. Not too tough now, is it? Time distortion is Lynette Shepherd's response. This digital photo collage of a deformed, mal-shapen sundial with butterfly wings represents something we all have experienced as we stay home for days at a time. What day is it? Is it really 1:15 p.m.? It was just 9 in the morning. I know we've all had that experience. Her other piece, I Don't Recognize This World, shows an amorphous world of clouds and nothing that is solid, even the Pentagon, appears translucent. For Lauren Kaprowski, the pandemic has provided time for sunset swims, an oil on panel piece where the figure and the water have become one. Jim Pollan is one of Maui's most in-demand printmaker, metalworker, and multimedia artist. Alternative Lens is a powerful work that includes acrylic paint, gold and silver leaf, all on aluminum panel. In the background are beautiful blossoms, but they have been obscured by the cacophony of phrases that remind us not only are we in a pandemic, but we are simultaneously confronting systemic white supremacy. 2020 will be a year historians will mark as long as there is scholarship. Unmasked digital photo art on panel by DeWitt Jones is such a potent image. Mr. Jones is one of the world's great photographers. He has been nominated for numerous Oscars, received one of the most coveted awards in photography, the Ansel Adams Award, and is a regular in National Geographic and many other publications. Unmasked is a frightening double entendre. It simultaneously tells the tale of the horror that can occur if one eschews a mask. And it uses the phrase as a metaphor for revealing something. The texture in the work is almost tactile. Cross-pollination, a diptych acrylic on panel by Gabriella Anderman, is a complex abstract of the way the coronavirus spreads on the microscopic level. Ms. Anderman portrays the ubiquity of the virus while depicting it in an almost interstellar environment, capturing its transcendent power and representing the magnifying threat it poses. Masks appear in many of the works. Here is Jack Hamilton's acrylic on panel, Handmade Masks. and Janet Davis's not too subtle oil on panels, Wear a Mask Malka and Wear a Mask Mackay, and Sherry McNerney's Cotton Yarn and Brass Nails Masked. Kathleen Castles is one of our finest fiber artists. This is her take on A Flood of Protests. It is a quilted painting wrap on panel. The violence is clear in the explosion of sanguine red. In the purple area can be discerned some mournful visages. Among the phrases that will echo in the canyons of protest and ironically in the ICUs of countless hospitals is, I can't breathe. Marlena Hubert depicts this duplicity forcefully. In this stunning tumbled glass wire and painted wood on panel work, there are a few artists who are couples and create works of art together. Ray Bella and the Powells come to mind most prominently. Add to that Marianne Lee, one of our most accomplished and creative ceramicists, and Don Smith, an outstanding sculptor. They created this hopeful ceramic and metal work, so close and yet so far, we shall be close again. It mourns the loss of the fraternal intimacy we enjoyed BC, before COVID, and demonstrates our willingness to embrace one another in the hopefully not too distant future. Terry Lopez oil and cold wax on panel reminds us of the time we could walk on the beach but couldn't sit. It captures the confusion and the blues and still the forlorn feeling that such an edict produced. But it's not all doom and gloom. Christine Wara has two encaustics on panels. Looking In has an optimistic energy to it. The work encourages us to go inside ourselves during this difficult time. There we will find the answers and hope. Her other work, Looking Out, shows tired eyes above a mask where the skewed red lip mouth tries to express itself through the cloth. It is at once pensive and penetrating. Linda Whittemore, who for so many years was one of our top monoprint artists on the island, has turned her exceptional talent toward oil painting. New Beginnings is a singular representation of the new paradigm, which the events we are all enduring, the pandemic, the confrontation of white supremacy, and the most important election in the history of the Republic may result in. The rosy color and the light in the work signify not only hope, but the promise of revelation for all humankind. Joel C.'s simple, elegant acrylic on panel bringing minds together shows not only it is easy to have harmony in the world, but it is what will save us from ourselves. Another positive expression comes from Diana Lehrer. Her Light in the Darkness and oil on panel work shows the gloom of the dark being overcome by the incipient light. It is like a new dawn breaking through the dark night of the soul. Then there is Susie Papanicolaou's marvelous expression of sharing aloha between indigenous Native Islanders and Native mainlanders. Entitled Hope, this acrylic on oil demonstrates not only the common agenda of indigenous peoples, but also the bond they share. Valerie Richter, one of Dick Nelson's tri-hue technique proteges, gives us this watercolor on panel. Love Song is a blossom of beauty and positivity. Its rosy hue also anoints its overall Panglossian energy. Martha Woodbury, one of our top abstract artists, contributed this ray of sunshine, Golden Turning Point, an acrylic on panel almost shouts with joy. The ebullient feelings it produces are palpable. Where everyone looks at this joyful piece, one can't help but smile and feel a sense of warmth and confidence in the future. Through the eyes of the artists will continue until the end of the year. I have just scratched the surface. There is so much notable work you will probably want to visit monthly. The mural will be changing constantly as newly created work is added. Maui artists always meet the challenges put before them with creativity and a reminder of the beauty surrounding us. Currently, the gallery at 3620 Baldwin Avenue in Makawao is open 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Saturdays and Sundays, and private viewings are available on any other day. Call 280-2845 or email oliver@viewpointsgallery.com to make an appointment for a private viewing. It's a great show and a chance to purchase our top artists at prices that won't break the bank, but will help support them and the gallery. Well, that's Curtain Call from a Distance for this week. Next week, I'll continue my review of this outstanding show. There is so much to talk about. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Paul James Brown. Ahui ho.